Hello, it is Monday, October the 22nd, the year 2012, and as usual, sports fans, a lot to get to in the sports world, so let's get it going right now. It was a busy weekend in the sports world. Let's start in the NFL. Let's go right to Houston. Houston Texans 43, Baltimore Ravens 13. The Houston Texans make a statement. They say, we are the best team in the AFC. Make no mistake about it. This was a matchup of the only two teams in the AFC that came in with an over 500 record, believe it or not, coming into the weekend. And the Houston Texans just demolished the Ravens in Houston. I mean, from pillar to post, from start to finish, defense, offense, special teams, Houston dominated. Schaub looked good. Foster running the ball great. The Houston defense, tremendous. And where was Baltimore yesterday? We know Baltimore has a lot of defensive problems. They're not a defensive team to begin with anyway. Ray Lewis out. Webb out. Nodder and Reed playing hurt. They get Suggs back. But where was the Baltimore offense? Baltimore is an offensive team now. Joe Flacco, where were you? Where were you, Ray Rice? An awful job by Baltimore. Not only getting blown out, but showing no heart in this game. Here's also what I don't like about Baltimore. They can be a bully team at home. They can bully you around at home. They can get their turnovers at home. They can be a very beatable team on the road. You saw that when they played the Chiefs this year in Kansas City and they won 9-6 and couldn't even get the ball in the end zone against a pathetic Chief defense. Baltimore and Flacco are very vulnerable on the road, and I did not like what I saw from Baltimore yesterday at all. I mean, they showed no heart. Houston pushed them all over the field. I mean, and Houston had not even looked great the last couple of weeks. On the Monday night against the Jets, they didn't look great, and they got bombed by Green Bay just last week at home. So Houston really rebounded here in a big way, and Baltimore fell flat on their face. Nice job by the Houston defense. They are playing without Cushing for the rest of the year. Houston defense just demolished Baltimore. Very impressed with Houston. Definitely the best team in the AFC right now. And I say the AFC, not the whole NFL, because I haven't forgotten what Green Bay did to them a week ago. Baltimore, they are 5-2. I don't want to go too crazy, but what a terrible job by them. Very shaky 5-2. Didn't like what I saw at all from Baltimore yesterday. Let's move on to Buffalo. Tennessee Titans 35, Buffalo Bills 34. Titans go to 3-4. That's two in a row for them. Buffalo drops to 3-4. What a horrible, atrocious, deplorable, despicable, ridiculous loss for the Buffalo Bills. You cannot lose to Tennessee in your own building. You have a 34-28 lead at the end of the game. Tennessee hassled back to Nate Washington with time, you know, running out, you know, on the big fourth down play to put Tennessee up 35-34. Tennessee wins the game. If you are Buffalo, you cannot lose to Tennessee in your building. You cannot let Tennessee score on fourth down at the end of the game to win that game. I mean, come on. Matt Hasselbeck's quarterbacking for Tennessee. He's long in the tooth. I mean, how do you lose to Tennessee at home? Tennessee has no defense at all. And finally, Johnson for Tennessee busts out. We've been waiting for him to bust out for a year. Leave it to the Buffalo defense to get him going again. What did Johnson have? 195 yards rushing yesterday? Almost 200 yards rushing against that Swiss cheese Buffalo defense. What happened to this ferocious front that I heard about all offseason that Buffalo was going to have? What happened to all these changes Buffalo on their defense that, you know, they added this guy and that guy and Mario Williams, and they're going to be ferocious in the defensive front. No one's going to score the ball against them, and they're going to be the surprise team in the league. What a bunch of garbage. Buffalo is not an elite team. They are a mediocre team. They are 8-8. I am not taking them seriously the rest of the year. They can't beat any of the big teams. Now they can't even beat Tennessee in their own building. Awful. Awful, atrocious job by the Bills up there at Orchard Park. Those fans deserve better than that slop they saw at the end of the game yesterday. Nice job by Tennessee. They are showing some life. They have won two in a row. Let's move on. I can't talk about that game any longer. Let's move on to Indianapolis. Colts 17, Cleveland 13. Colts go to 3-3. Cleveland drops to 1-6. I said from the start of the season, the Colts are going to be good at home. They're going to not travel well. That's just the case here. They're 3-1 at home. They win another home game yesterday. It could be 4-0 at home. They lost a terrible game at Jacksonville. They never should have lost. And they're not good on the road, the Colts. They've got blown out by the Bears, blown out by the Jets. They're not going to travel well. Luck's going to play much better in the friendly confines of the retractable dome there in Indianapolis. Cleveland, going to be a long year. We know that. They have a lot of talent. They have shown a little more competitiveness lately. They beat Cincinnati last week. They hung in there with the Giants. They hung in there with the Ravens. You know, Wheaton's looked a little better. He had a nice game yesterday. What was he, 25 for 41, 264, two touchdowns. He's showing some improvement. It's going to be a long road back for Cleveland. They just don't have a lot of talent. 1-6, long year for them. Colts, going to be good at home, bad on the road. Let's move on. Green Bay 30, St. Louis 20 in St. Louis. Green Bay goes to 4-3. St. Louis drops to 3-4. Green Bay's getting hot. Watch out. They had the big win in Houston last week. They come back on the road again, beat St. Louis. St. Louis doesn't have the firepower to go toe-to-toe with a team like Green Bay. They don't have a lot of offensive weapons. I do like Bradford. I like Fisher, what he's doing as the coach. Defense plays hard. They need a little time, St. Louis, to get better. They need some more weapons. They can't hang with Green Bay at this stage. Green Bay's getting hot. Watch out. They're 4-3, two in a row. Could be 5-2. Should have beat Seattle in that debacle on Monday night. We all know that. Watch out for Green Bay. They are getting hot. Aaron Rodgers looks like he's getting red hot. Did you see the laser beam he threw? He was rolling left in one play of the game. He threw a laser beam into the end zone for a touchdown. What an arm by him. Just a laser beam. Still unbelievable to me after all these years that Rodgers dropped so far in the draft and that Alex Smith was taken ahead of him by San Francisco. Still mind-boggling to me, but I don't want to dwell on that. Green Bay getting hot. Watch out for him. St. Louis showing definitely signs of improvement. It's going to take a little while there for Fisher to rebuild that team. Let's move on. Let's go to Minnesota. Minnesota at home beats Arizona 21-14. Minnesota goes to 5-2. Arizona drops to 4-3. Minnesota, the shock of the NFL. They won three games last year. They are 5-2. I mean, 5-2 Minnesota. And how about Adrian Peterson? Adrian Peterson had a catastrophic knee injury at the end of last season. He's not only already back playing, he's playing at a very high level. He had another tremendous game yesterday. Minnesota defense all over the field. Allen all over the field. Winfield all over the field. 7 sacks. I mean, Ponder didn't even have a great game yesterday for Minnesota. He didn't do anything at quarterback. Minnesota still found a way to win. They get the big interception return. They make Skelton fumble. Skelton did have a decent game filling in for Cobb, but he did have two big turnovers. One was run back for a touchdown, and he had another big fumble. I mean, Arizona did move the ball a lot. They actually outgained the Vikings by a lot, but the two big turnovers cost them. And the 7 sacks. Arizona keeps giving up a lot of sacks. Every time they get something going, they take another sack. Arizona is improved. They are 4-3. I do like their defense. Quarterback situation with Skelton Cobb, shaky. Running backs always hurt, shaky. They have Fitzgerald, no one really to compliment him. So the offense still very shaky, defense very good. We know Arizona's going to be good at home. Can they win big games on the road? Minnesota 5-2. I can't say enough good things about this team. They won three games last year. Great job by the coaching staff by the Vikings at 5-2. Tremendous job. Let's move on. Giants at home beat the Redskins 27-23. Giants go to 5-2. Redskins drop to 3-4. The Giants just play 4 games within a game. They look great. They look bad. They look okay. They're just all over the board in the same game. This is what we know about the Giants. At the end of the game, Eli will make a play. There's no doubt about it. If Eli has the ball in his hands with a chance to win the game, he's going to do it. And here's another thing about the Giants. The Giants can beat any team, anywhere, anytime. I don't care if you play the game on the moon. If the Giants get in the playoffs, they can beat anyone. Now, from the Washington standpoint, 3-4, very competitive. We love Robert Griffin III. He's going to be a star. Daniel Snyder, the owner of the Redskins, finally has his star quarterback. He's going to be a star. He's dynamic. He's electric. We love his personality. He's doing everything he can to keep Washington in these games. They actually took the lead at the end of this game, Washington, before inexplicably they gave up the big pass to Victor Cruz. I don't know how Victor Cruz gets behind the Washington defense, you know, with very little time left in that situation. Terrible job by the Redskins defense. But back to Washington and Robert Griffin III. They're going to have a bright future with him. I mean, right now, Redskins have no offensive line, not a lot of weapons, a lot of injuries, bad defense, and he's still keeping them in all these games. Future looks bright for Washington. This year, he's going to do all he can to keep them in the games. Listen, they're not going to do much this year, Washington. Maybe they go 8-8. Future looks bright, though. Giants, as long as they get in the playoffs, they can beat anyone. Let's move on. All right, let's go down to Tampa. New Orleans Saints, when they're second in a row, they go to 2-4. They beat Tampa Bay 35-28. Tampa drops to 2-4. A lot of people are saying the Saints are back. I'm not one of them. The Saints did win. We know Breeze is spectacular. They can score against anybody. their defense is atrocious. I mean, they gave up a ton of yardage to Tampa Bay and Freeman yesterday. I mean, they were lucky to hang on and win this game. Tampa Bay actually scores a touchdown with no time left, but they say Williams, the receiver, stepped out before he caught the ball. Good call. He definitely did. So New Orleans hangs on in this game. I'm not a believer in the Saints. I know some people are. Their defense is not any good. Tampa Bay playing really hard this year. Doesn't have a lot to show for it. They've been in every game. They're only 2-4. Biggest play of the game, I thought, in this game. 28-21 Saints, third quarter. Tampa Bay pinned back in their own territory. Freeman throws a deep pass to Jackson, who's running down the sidelines with looks like the game-tying touchdown. Now, Jackson doesn't have great speed, but what a great hustle play by the defender Jenkins for the Saints. He catches Jackson at the one-yard line. From there, the Saints actually come up with a defensive stand. They stop Tampa on three straight running plays, and then on fourth down, Freeman gets stopped on a bootleg. I didn't like the play calling by Tampa there either on those four plays. Saints actually make a great stop there, and from there they go on to score and go up 35-21. It was uphill all the way for Tampa from there. That play really changed the course of this game. So great hustle play by the defender Jenkins, tracking down Jackson at the one-yard line. Jackson looked like he was free and clear for the tying score. Nice job by the Saints. They are showing some life. I'm not a big believer. Tampa Bay and Shiano playing hard. Not a lot to show for it. I do like they are playing hard. Let's move on. Let's go down to Carolina. Dallas goes to 3-3. They beat Carolina 19-14. Carolina drops to 1-5. Carolina's been atrocious this year. They just fired the GM, Cam Newton. What's happened to him? Sophomore jinx. He looks terrible. Defense actually played decent for one of the first times this year, but they still lose. Now the offense can't score. Dallas, nice job by their D. You know, it's funny. Even when Dallas wins, I still am wanting more from them. To me, I wanted them to win this game yesterday, like 34-17, just bury Carolina. You want to see like a big, dominant performance from Dallas. Again, they're struggling, they're bumbling, they let Carolina take the lead at one point. Never a complete performance by Dallas. There's still something missing by them. I don't want to kill them. They did win. It's a road win. They are 3-3. Still something missing. Maybe it's the coach. I don't love Garrett. I just have a feeling Dallas needs a big coach down there, like a Cow or a Gruden, a big personality like that. They do get the win. They are 3-3. Carolina, long year for them, 1-5. They do fire the GM. Let's move on. Real quick, the Thursday night game, San Francisco at home. Beat Seattle 13-6 in an absolute slugfest. I mean, San Francisco goes to 5-2. I haven't liked what I've seen from San Francisco recently. They got manhandled by Minnesota, destroyed by the Giants at home. They didn't even look great in this game. Seattle had a lot of chances in the first half, a lot of drop passes by Seattle, but San Francisco is 5-2. Alex Smith a little shaky lately. Niners not quite as dominant as we thought they'd be. Seattle, nice defense, great home team. Can they do it on the road? Can Wilson do it on the road at quarterback? Are we going to see Flynn at quarterback at some point? He's the backup they got from Green Bay. They paid him a lot of money. He's the backup there. Seattle's defense playing well enough to win. Do they keep going with Wilson? He did have that nice comeback win against the Patriots, you know, a couple weeks ago. How long do you stay with him? You don't want to waste these good defensive efforts because your offense can't do anything, especially on the road. Keep an eye on that. So the Niners did get the win there, 5-2. Little shaky, 5-2. Seattle, 4-3. Good home team, not a good road team. We'll see about the quarterback. Defense playing great. Let's move on. Jacksonville at Oakland yesterday. Oakland gets the win in overtime, 26-23. Oakland rallies. Jacksonville absolutely blew this game. Garrett, the quarterback, goes out for Jacksonville with an injury. We'll see about him. Jones Drew goes out with an injury for Jacksonville. We'll see about him. Jacksonville's 1-5. It's going to be a long year for Jacksonville. They could be the worst team in all of football. Just a long year for them. They could have won this game yesterday. Totally blew it. Give Oakland credit. They did rally. They are showing signs of life. They are only 2-4. I don't think they're going anywhere. Could have beat Atlanta last week. Did beat the Steelers this year. Nice job by Palmer rallying him. Janikowski, the big field goal in overtime after Jacksonville fumbles on their first possession. Good job by Palmer also in this game. Late in the game in the fourth quarter, about 4 minutes to go, Oakland's down 7 with no timeouts left. Oakland coach wanted to kick a field goal to make it 4 with no time left with about 4 minutes to go. Carson Palmer said, no, let's go for it. Keep the offense on the field. They did. They end up getting a pass interference call in Jacksonville. They end up getting a touchdown right there and tying the game. Good job by Palmer talking the coach out of that. I don't know why the coach would want to kick a field goal there with no time left. I mean, then you got to give the ball back to Jacksonville, stop them, and then go down the field and score a touchdown anyway. Good job by Palmer talking him out of that. Oakland gets the win. Nice job by them. Jacksonville, long year for them. All right, let's move on to New England. New England absolutely escapes at home yesterday. They go to 4-3. The Jets drop to 3-4. New England 29, Jets 26 in overtime. The Jets played hard. They battled. They came back. The defense kept them in the game the first half. The Jets, once again, still made too many mistakes, though. Sanchez with a big interception in the first half. The fumble at the in overtime. The Jets with a big drop ball at the end of the game there by the rookie that could have maybe won the game for the Jets if they kept possession of the ball there instead of having to kick the field goal. Jets, too many mistakes. Again, they did play hard. I have to give them credit. They played really hard. They probably deserved a better fate in this game. New England, what's going on with you? 4-3, can't hold the lead in the fourth quarter again. Lucky to win this game. I mean, get two big kicks by Gostkowski. I mean, one to send the game into overtime, then another one to win the game in overtime. They were lucky to escape here in New England. They, after they fumbled the kickoff, after the Jets had tied the game, you think New England's going to lose right there and then. They do come down the field and end up tying the game in regulation. They do win it in overtime. I don't want to pick on them too much because they did win. They are 4-3, a long season to go. They are in first place. They're looking shaky, New England, especially on defense. I thought this defense was supposed to be improved. This defense looks worse than ever. They can't stop anyone in a big spot. I mean, and come playoff time, that's what it's all about. And New England is about Super Bowls, not about winning the division, not about making plays. It's about Super Bowls. And remember back to last year. I mean, you know, when they lost the Super Bowl, the Giants couldn't make a big stop. A few years ago against the Giants, couldn't make a big stop then. New England has trouble making big stops in a big spot in the fourth quarter. And once again, we're seeing it. Their defense was shredded by Sanchez. How many passes to Curley did he have yesterday? So New England gets the win, very shaky 4-3. Nice job by the Jets as far as playing hard. Defense hung in the game. Probably deserved better, but no moral victories. Another loss for the Jets. They're 3-4. All right, let's move on. The Sunday night game, Cincinnati and Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh with a much-needed win. Pittsburgh goes to 3-3. Much-needed win. Must win for the Steelers. They couldn't afford to go to 2-4. Cincinnati now lost 3 in a row. They were 3-1. Now they're 3-4. They're struggling. Steelers actually got off to a bad start in this game. They're down 14-3, and I'm sitting there going, my goodness, are the Steelers going to lose another game? They dominate the second half. They dominate all phases of the game. I mean, the Steelers defense really played well the second half. Give Ike Taylor credit. He played A.J. Green really tough. Even without Polamalu on defense yesterday, the Steelers defense dominated the second half. Steelers had over 400 yards of total offense. Cincinnati, I don't even think, had 200 yards. I didn't like the Cincinnati play calling either. Gruden's usually a good play caller for Cincinnati. Not yesterday. Very conservative. A lot of running. No deep shots against that shaky Steelers D. Didn't like the play calling for Cincinnati at all. And a nice job by Pittsburgh getting this win. A really nice job by them coming back and winning this game. Watch Pittsburgh now start to play a lot better, and don't count them out. They have the talent. If they get Polamalu back, don't count them out. They are capable of beating any team in the AFC if everyone is healthy and they're playing right, and especially if they're playing in Pittsburgh. All right, let's move on. I want to touch real quick on the college football. Let's go over a few things in college football. What happened on Saturday? Florida in the swamp, another huge win. Florida dismantles South Carolina 44-11. Florida, number 2 in the BCS, undefeated. They've gone to Texas A&M this year and won. Went to Tennessee and won. Beat LSU and South Carolina at home. What a great job by Florida. Beginning of the year, Muschamp, they were saying, was on the hot seat. The hot seat, they're in contention for a national title here. I mean, my goodness, to me, I want Muschamp, who came over from Texas, if you remember, Muschamp was the coach in waiting at Texas. Mack Brown signs the extension there. Muschamp is his assistant. He's a coach in waiting whenever Mack Brown decides to retire. Mack Brown signs an extension. Muschamp decides not to wait for Mack Brown to retire. He ends up taking the job at Florida, and what a great move by Florida. And I'll tell you, Texas is going to rue that decision because Mack Brown looks looks a lot long in the tooth right now at Texas. They're not playing well. I'd much rather have the younger Muschamp as my coach. And what a great job he's done with this Florida team. Amazing, the Florida fans thought he might be on the hot seat this year. I guess Florida is very spoiled. They had Spurrier, they had Urban Meyer. They want to win basically every game they play. Muschamp, tremendous job. And South Carolina and Spurrier have fallen flat on their face here. South Carolina dominated Georgia just a few weeks ago. Now they have two losses. They lose to LSU last week. Now they get bombed by Florida. South Carolina's out of the national championship hunt. Just in 2 weeks, they're out. In the SEC, if you lose one game, you can rebound, not two. South Carolina out, and Steve Spurrier, he's going to be throwing that visor a lot during the rest of this season. Not a good job by South Carolina the last 2 weeks. All right, let's move. By the way, Florida, big game this week. We'll touch on this as the week goes on. Florida, Georgia, the outdoor cocktail party in Jacksonville. We'll touch on that game as it comes up. All right. Notre Dame, 17, BYU, 14 at Notre Dame. Notre Dame stays undefeated. Defense continues to play well at Oklahoma this week. Very tough game. We'll touch on that game on Wednesday. Kansas State. How about Kansas State? They go to 7-0. They're undefeated. They demolish West Virginia at Morgantown, 55-14. What in the world has happened to West Virginia? What in the world has happened to them the last 2 weeks? They've gotten bowled over by Texas Tech and now by Kansas State, and by Kansas State at home. West Virginia never takes a beating like that at home. Great job by Bill Schneider, the coach of Kansas State. Great job by the quarterback, Klein, for Kansas State. He's a Heisman candidate. I love what I see from Kansas State. What an unbelievable job they've done. Nice job by them. West Virginia, terrible defense, awful, showing no heart at all. All right, let's move on. Oregon State at home also stays undefeated. They beat Utah 21-7. Mike Riley, another tremendous job as a coach. What a great job he's done. Oregon State, not an easy place to win. So nice job by them. They have some big games coming up. LSU saves their season. They go to Texas A&M. They beat Texas A&M in College Station 24-19. They're down 12-0 early in this game. They rally to win. They keep their season alive. They only have one loss. They play Bama in 2 weeks after an off week this week. LSU is back in contention. Now, I don't love LSU's offense. I still think they have a long way to go. I think Bama is a much better team than them. LSU does get them at home in Death Valley, so keep an eye on that. But LSU, make no mistake about it, saved their season with this win against A&M. Alabama blows out Tennessee in Knoxville. Mississippi stays undefeated. Mississippi State actually plays Alabama this week in Alabama before Alabama has the big game against LSU the week after. Mississippi State hasn't played anyone this year. This is a big step up for them. We'll touch on this game as the week goes on. Alabama, Mississippi State, interesting game, but a big step up for in competition for Mississippi State. Alabama, though, you don't want to be sleeping here because you do have LSU in 2 weeks. You don't want to overlook Mississippi State. Georgia 29, Kentucky 24 in Lexington. What's going on with Georgia? I mean, what is going on with them? They get bombed by South Carolina 2 weeks ago. They have a week off. You figure they're going to rebound here and bury a bad Kentucky team. They struggle to win in Lexington. Not like what I'm seeing from Georgia, especially going into the big game against Florida, a game they never win, by the way. Not liking the body language of Georgia at all. Rutgers stays undefeated in the Big East. Louisville stays undefeated in the Big East. Cincinnati does lose. They lose their perfect record. They lose to Toledo. Clemson beats Virginia Tech in the other Death Valley in Clemson, 38-17. Frank Beamer and Virginia Tech 4-4, lost season for them. Stanford wins the big game 21-3 over Cal. It's funny, the big game usually is played at the end of the year, now it's kind of the middle of the year. Stanford has a nice team, they have a nice program. Cal, what's going on with Cal? 3-5, new renovated stadium there in Berkeley. What's going on with Tedford, the coach? He's on the hot seat. 3-5, losing to Stanford. You can't do that. You can't have a new renovated stadium be 3-5 and lose to Stanford in the big game. Terrible job by Cal. I don't know what's going to go on with the coach there because they still owe him years and, you know, a lot of money. So I don't know if they could just get rid of him. Don't know if they want to eat that contract. He's definitely on the hot seat, though. Ohio State escapes again. They stay unbeaten at 29-22 over Purdue. The quarterback, Miller, hurt. We'll keep an eye on him. Ohio State goes to Penn State this week. Ohio State undefeated. They are on probation, so they can't go anywhere. Urban Meyer doing a nice job with that team. They seem to escape every week, but they do win. Look for Ohio State to have a big year next year. How about Duke? How about Duke, 6-2? How about the job Cutliff, the coach, is doing at Duke? Duke 6-2 beats North Carolina 33-30 in Durham. Nice job by Duke. An impossible place to build a program as far as football. I mean, they're a basketball school. Great job by Cutliff there. Auburn, where are you this year? Auburn's 1-6. They lost to Vanderbilt. 1-6. Auburn is a few years away from a national championship. They won a national championship with Cam Newton a few years ago. What happened to all these five-star recruits they were supposed to have? Terrible job by Auburn. Terrible job by the coaching. What's with these five-star recruits? 1-6? Auburn's the type of team that just throws their helmet on the field. They get 6 wins. I can't believe how bad they've been this year. 1-6, awful. Michigan in the big house. They beat Michigan State 12-10. Nice job by Michigan. They get the field goal at the end. Michigan State, very disappointing. 4-4, good defense, no offense, though. Very disappointing. Southern Miss 0-7.
get bombed by Marshall at home. Southern Miss was one of those good little programs for years. I remember when I was a little kid, like 5 years old, watching Brett Favre and Southern Miss beat Florida State in Jacksonville 1 year. Southern Miss 0-7, what's going on with that program? I got to give credit to Penn State and the coaching staff. Penn State's won five in a row with all the turmoil there. They were 0-2. They've won five in a row. They go to Iowa, beat Iowa 38-14. Iowa's not a great team at all this year. Big Ten a little down this year in general. Nice job by Penn State hanging in there. They were 0-2 and just looking like they're going to have just a miserable season with all the scandal, the players leaving. Five in a row. Nice job by Penn State and the coaching staff keeping that game, keeping that team together. They actually have a big game this week at Happy Valley against Ohio State. You know, both teams are on probation. They can't go anywhere. It's a big game, though. Big game. I hope they get a nice turnout there at Penn State. Nice job by them keeping it together. Florida State beats Miami 33-20. This game used to be the game of the year. Miami is just not having a great year at all. Al Golden is trying his best to keep it together. Sanctions are coming from Miami, no doubt. All sorts of problems. No defense. People are saying Florida State is still in the national championship hunt. I don't buy it. Not with the loss they had to NC State. That was an atrocious loss. They blew that game to an average NC State team. I don't see Florida State getting back into the hunt. The ACC is weak. They're not going to have too many big games outside of the Florida game. Florida State wins here. I don't think they're getting in the national championship hunt. The NC State game buried them. All right, let's move on real quick to the baseball. We have a Game 7 tonight. Very exciting to have a Game 7 in baseball. The Giants win last night, Game 6. They beat the Cardinals 6-1. Tonight we have Matt Cain against Loesch on the mound in San Francisco. You got to favor the Giants with Cain on the mound at home, but don't ever count out St. Louis. This is a team that you just can never kill. I mean, last year we thought Texas was going to beat them in the World Series a couple times. St. Louis ends up taking the title last year. And once again this year, they're back in, you know, the AL Championship game. So you just cannot kill this St. Louis team. You can't write them off. Same thing goes for the Giants. The Giants were down 2-0 to Cincinnati after losing 2 games at home. They win 3 games against the Reds in Cincinnati. They're down 3-1 now against St. Louis. And here they come and tie the series. So two teams that won't die. And let's not forget the Cardinals rally against the Washington Nationals. The Nationals had them beaten. They rallied in that series. So two teams that refuse to lose should be a really exciting Game 7. Game 7s are always fun. Of course, the Tigers are waiting there, you know, for the winner of this game to play in the World Series. Tigers have had off for a few days now. So it should be a nice World Series depending on, you know, no matter who the Tigers play, whether it be the Giants or the Cardinals, it should be a very exciting World Series. So keep an eye on that game tonight. Also keep an eye on the big Monday Night Division game tonight. Detroit Lions, Chicago Bears. Chicago Bears, ferocious defense. Detroit Lions, big win against Philly, need to follow it up. They're only 2-3. Can't afford to go to 2-4 in that tough division. Lions need to really build on their performance. The last week won't be easy at historic Soldier Field. That Bear defense is playing really well. Bear offense, you know, always can be shaky. Very interesting Monday night game. Also, I want to say congratulations to the Indiana Fever who won the WNBA title, so congratulations to them. Also, I want to give a nice little pop to the Barclays Center and the boxing. They held boxing over there on Saturday. The Barclays Center in Brooklyn, brand new arena where the Nets are going to play. They're going to have a lot of boxing there. They're going to have a lot of college basketball there. If you're ever in the New York area, check it out. Looks like a gorgeous arena. Looks like the area around it's very nice. Looks like it's very easy to get to. Definitely check out the Barclays Center. They had a nice crowd there. They didn't have a sellout crowd because they didn't have really a big name. But Garcia beats Morales in the main event. Garcia looks like a nice fighter. Morales needs to hang it up. Morales was a great champion. He looked shot. He took a vicious shot that knocked him down and knocked him out of this fight. I'm very worried if he keeps fighting about his health. He also tested positive for some drug test, but was allowed to fight because of some technicality. Morales is shot. He needs to hang it up. Garcia looks like a nice fighter. Looks like he could have some big fights down the road. The crowd, even though it wasn't a sellout, very knowledgeable crowd there in Brooklyn. Paulie Malignaggi, who got a win, a very controversial win, who was a local fighter, actually got booed. That's how, you know, that's give a lot of credit to the Brooklyn fans there. Usually, you know, if the hometown fighter wins, you know, they're cheering no matter what. They actually booed Malignaggi because they thought he lost. He could very well have. But a very knowledgeable crowd there in Brooklyn. And by the way, keep an eye on this fighter. Kid Chalkwood, very exciting fighter that was on the card, had a nice, exciting win. keep an eye on him. He looks like a nice, exciting fighter. He kind of stole the show on Saturday night. Kid Chalka, keep an eye on him. Nice prospect there. So Barclays Center, if you're ever in the Brooklyn area, get down there. Looks like a gorgeous arena. Looks like a nice place to watch either boxing, you know, college basketball. They're going to have concerts, every kind of event there. And of course, the Brooklyn Nets, formerly the New Jersey Nets, will be playing their home games there. All right, so tonight, keep an eye on the Monday Night Football, Lions Bears. Keep an eye on Game 7, Giants Cardinals. Tomorrow we're going to touch on the Monday Night Football game. We're going to discuss what happened there. We're going to talk about Game 7. We're going to preview the World Series. Wednesday, wall-to-wall college football. Thursday, wall-to-wall NFL. We're going to touch on the baseball as well. We're going to fill in, you know, anything else going on in the sports world. You guys stay safe. Have a great day. Enjoy the games tonight, and I will talk to you soon. Take care.